I can't play larger than life characters. I can't play a man beating up 25 people, you know.
Hitting on a flop doesn't bother you.
Except that I can increase my price.
Can we see that romantic angle as well with Madhuri?
Yeah, I believe so. That won't be difficult at all. To start lusting after Madhuri, no problem.
Absolutely. There was a point of time after Tridevi when you were having quite an interesting part of commercial cinema after that. There was
I realized that I didn't quite fit into those movies. You know, I had a few successes like Tridevi and Mohra, but I don't really fit into that kind of cinema. I can't play larger than life characters. I can't play heroic, you know, without laughing into my sleeve. I can't play a man beating up 25 people, you know. I can play true-to-life parts. I can play vulnerable characters. I can play the twisted characters. I can play the lech. I can play the villain. But I'm not cut out to play a conventional leading man in commercial Hindi movies. I've realized that a bit late.
In fact, a movie that has not released of yours, it's called The Hunt. And you've said that in a way it is Jalwa Part 2 for you. The director has not intended it that to be. The pictures of that particular movie are looking very good. You're playing a guy who's actually nurturing some sort of drugs and all. He's hiding in a jungle and that sort of stuff. What really happened to that movie? And I think you should ask
the man who made it. I think I'll give you his phone number. You can call him up and ask him. I have no idea. It's complete, more than a year it's been complete and nobody's touching it. I think if you see the film, you'll understand why.
It's like really dark.
It's very artistic.
It's very artistic?
So artistic that nobody understands it except the guy who made it. Right. And I doubt if even he does.
What makes you do these? You've done many,
because,
many.
Yeah. He came to me again. See, I recently did a film called Charlie Ke Chakkar Mein, which is a thriller made by a bunch of young people. Made, completed within 25-30 lakhs.
Right.
My heart went out to these people. They asked me, would I play a small role? I said yes, happily, and I did it. The film is complete. It's a very good film. The fellow who made The Hunt came to me with a similar story, that he was making an action film in 25 lakhs, and I've always believed that successful films can be made very cheaply.
You've said that.
Yeah. And so I went into it with this conviction, that here we had some great material on our hands, and we could make a film which can't possibly lose. If we can swing it in 25 lakhs, and we could, and we did, it's just that the film itself doesn't make any sense. And the guy who made it refused to be drawn into any kind of a discussion on it. And so he's made this thing which is completely incomprehensible.
I think in today's day and age, you have avenues of recovering money and all. I'm sure that there's television, there's DVD and lot
of... The film has got to make one iota of sense at least, you know.
You yourself don't find it interesting?
I don't understand it. I've seen it twice and I don't understand it. And I'm acting in it.
So you've also said that about the budgeting in the movie, that recently you've said that too much of money is spent on too many irrelevant things many a time. Yeah. Nishant, I believe, was made at 3.5 lakh rupees at that point of time, and you still stand by that cinema. Jaane Bhi Do Yaaron, I think, is a perfect example as well. What is your take on this aspect, that too much is emphasized on box office and 100 crores and weekend aapka kitna
half of it is wastage.
Right.
On a big commercial movie, tons of money is wasted. Which really angers me, makes me very, very upset. I still believe a film like Ishqiya could and should have been made on a smaller budget.
Okay.
But since it was not, I charged my pound of flesh. Why should I reduce my price?
Absolutely.
If there's going to be lavish expenditure and everything else?
Absolutely.
It should have been made on the kind of budget a Wednesday was made. Wednesday is such a big success because it was made on a tiny budget.
Absolutely.
So, if I'm confronted with a monumental budget of film on 100 crores, then I make sure I get a fat slice of the pie. Mm. Why should I not? But I'm still all for... I refuse to abandon my belief that someday a 25 lakh, 30 lakh movie is going to bust the box office. It's going to happen here.
Right.
Like it happened in Hollywood.
Great. Any chances of a sequel to a Wednesday by any chance? Do you think there is a possibility over there? Because the guy is still around. He's still...
But he hasn't done a damn thing since a Wednesday.
Neeraj has been
remade in Tamil and Telugu and God knows what else.
Right.
I don't know. I think it's ripe for a sequel.
Absolutely.
I hope it is made, but I don't know. There's no sign of it. He's at the moment involved in something else.
Right, special Chhabbis. Okay, so you've also said that you've liked the work of what was done by Dilip Kumar Sahab in his early days and Amitabh Bachchan, pre-Zanjeer era and all. Aapne apne kaam ko bhi aapne bahut hi ruthlessly aapne usko, you've just tore it apart. Many times you've said that on the sets of Junoon, there were people on the sets who used to clap after you've given a shot and you did not like it because that gives a false sense of delusion to an actor. How can you be so ruthlessly honest with yourself as well as about whatever happens?
Because to me, bettering my abilities is more important than anything else in the world. And I don't see anything to be gained by diplomacy. It's different to be disrespectful. And I don't think I've ever been disrespectful to Mr. Dilip Kumar or Mr. Bachchan. But I have been forthright. If that displeases them, then that's too bad. I would appreciate if they bothered to see my work, the same kind of feedback from them. But I don't think either of them has seen much of my work. And I can be so ruthless with myself because I realize that it's pointless deluding yourself. I need still to prove something to myself, I guess. I was a worthless child. I was a bad student. I came last in class. I was, sort of dismissed as a person who would amount to nothing. The horrors of that kind of treatment as a child still stay with me, and they are very fresh, and I can never, never quite come to terms with them. I think I still need to prove something to myself. That is why I try to be as honest as possible about my own work and about others' work as well.
What are the works of Dilip Kumar Sahab that you feel are phenomenal?
Everything pre-Ganga Jamna. Everything pre-Ganga.
You don't think Karma is good enough? You guys are supposed
I've never seen Karma, actually.
You've never seen Karma?
I've seen bits of it.
All right.
I couldn't be bothered with the whole film. It was too long.
Even after it became a huge hit?
Yeah.
Hit and a flop doesn't bother you?
Except that I can increase my price.
So, Dear Ishqiya is coming on. You're excited about working with Madhuri Dixit.
Yes, I'm excited.
You said that you're a fan of Madhuri.
I'm a fan of Madhuri. I'm also a fan of Abhishek. I think Abhishek is a terrific
Abhishek
filmmaker.
Chabit, right.
I'm really looking forward. If asked, frankly, asked to weigh in the balance, I'm more excited about the prospect of Abhishek, working with Abhishek. That doesn't decrease my excitement of working with Madhuri. Who my co-star is has been of little consequence to me at every stage of my career. I do not consider it my business to pass judgment on a co-actor.
Right.
That I kisko le liya kind of thing. I never say these things. I work with whoever I'm cast with. I was terribly excited about working with Dilip Sahab, but he was the only one. There was no one else who, I dreamt of working with and so on. If it doesn't work out with Madhuri, it'll be someone else. But I'm really excited at the prospect of working with Chobe.
You have this, your character lusts after Vidya in Ishqa, in fact. Can we see that romantic angle as well with Madhuri?
Yeah, I believe so. That won't be difficult at all. To start lusting after Madhuri, no problem.
Absolutely. My next question to you will be, Dirty Picture, I think you have some serious lovemaking scenes with Vidya Balan. In 40-84, you are having some item songs to just go along. Do you enjoy the entire perks of cinema?
No, I enjoyed Dirty Picture very much.
Right.
I loved every moment of it. Vidya is a lovely person. She's very, very trusting and very open and very simple. And I really like working with her. Bunty Luthria I have known for a very long time and I've always been very fond of him. He's taught me a bit of horse riding and stuff and he also likes me. So it's mutual. And it was sheer enjoyment and fun. I had no terribly demanding dramatic scenes to do. And I loved taking the Mickey out of that character, It was great fun. Then doing these dance numbers is not fun because it's very hard work. I'm not very good at it.
I think the mannerisms and everything that came out in Ooh La La, I think that was great fun. People just enjoyed it. The song is a blockbuster in itself. It's like an idiom in its own way.
I got it right after 35 years of practice.
You've said that as well about the song in that as well. So one more question to you will be that you've said that Pankaj Parashar is one of your favorite directors.
Yes.
And any chances of Jalwa 2 by any chance, you think?
No, not with Pankaj.
Not with Pankaj. But it's a possibility apart from that.
Well, about half a dozen other writers have approached me with potential scripts for Jalwa 2. None of them has materialized. Pankaj keeps talking about it every time we meet. But I don't think it'll ever happen. I think it should be left alone.
Jaane Bhi Toh Yaaron Part 2, any chances?
No, that also should be left alone. And now Ravi is gone, Bhakti is gone. Everybody else has become like a pumpkin. Satish Kaushik, etc., etc. They've all changed beyond recognition. I don't think it should be. Should let it be. It's a good memory. Let it be.
Fantastic. That was Nasiruddin Shah talking about his next film, Maximum, and a whole lot of very, very interesting things. We can just keep on talking about a lot of things because the man is, I think, encyclopedia of cinema and experiences and a whole lot of other things as well. Thank you very much, sir. Lovely to have you and all the best wishes for Maximum
and
all of your future ventures. That's all we're from Bora Rangama. Keep on watching.